Today I am teaching you SFD BMD of cantilever beam. This is the cantilever beam. These are the point loads and this is the uniform distribution load, because it is a UDL. Now I am considering the shear force. The arrow downward is positive and upward is negative for shear force. For bending moment, sagging positive and hogging negative I will consider. For bending moment. Now first, this is a UDL. I will convert into a point load. This is the point load as it is, 20 kilonewton at B, 1 meter, 10 kilonewton. Here UDL has converted into a point load. That means 12 into 2, you have to multiply 12 into 2 because it is a uniform distribution load, and that point load will be at the centroid, at the center of this line. That is 12 into 22 is nothing but 24 kilonewton, because meter get cancelled here. Now exactly at the center, then the length here will be 1 meter and 1 meter apart. This will be D and this will be C. See, there is a one more load acting at the C, that is 15 kilonewton, and this end is fixed here, 1 meter. First, I will write the shear force. Shear force at B, because there is a point load, I will consider left and right. This right at B, right side it will be zero. On left side, SFB on left of this scale will be 20 kilonewton, because the downward I will consider as a positive. Now at D, because there is a point load, therefore you have to consider left and right. SFD at right, because I am moving from the towards the left, therefore first I will consider right, then I will consider left. 20, the previous number you have to write, 20 kilonewton you can write it. Next, SF D at left side, previous number 20 plus this 10 is nothing but 30 kilonewton. Now at C, don't consider at here, you have to consider only at the points where the alphabets are mentioned. Okay, at C again there is a point load, therefore you have to consider right and left. SF C at right side. At right side, first write the previous number, 30 plus 24, that means 10, 20 plus 30 plus 24 is nothing but, you will get answer 24, otherwise previous plus 24, you will get the same answer. The answer for this one will be 54 kilonewton. Now similarly at A, there is no load, therefore single alphabet has to be used. Same previous value will be appear, because 20 plus 10 plus 24 plus 15 is nothing but 54. Oh sorry, I missed here. SF at left will be 54 plus 15 is nothing but 69 kilonewton, because I have to consider left and right. I have considered the right, I have to consider left. At the right, only this force, 20 plus 10 plus 24. On the left, 20 plus 10 plus 24 into 15, that means previous value plus 15, you will get 69 kilonewton. And there is no load, therefore directly write single alphabet, that is A. That is previous value, 69 kilonewton. That means 20 plus 10 plus 24 plus 15 is nothing but 69 kilonewton. Now I will draw the shear force diagram. The first value is 69. This is 69 kilonewton. There is no load. Next, at C, there are two points, left and right. First is 69, therefore we have to draw a straight line because there is a no load. 69, straight line, it should be a straight line. 69, one more, 54, here 54 kilonewton downward. Next at D, 30 kilonewton, at D, 30 kilonewton, again at D, 20 is there, 20, but UDL is there. Because of UDL, here inclined line appears, inclined line, because of UDL the inclined line appears. Again straight line, at B again 20, at B 20 and 0, there is no load, there is no UDL, therefore straight line. If UDL appears, then you have to draw the inclined line in shear force. This is positive, this is positive and this is positive. I will go for bending moment, BM. Now bending moment I will consider from the left side. The SFD I will start from the towards the right, from the right to left, and BMD from left to right. First I will consider BMD at A. BM at A, that means here this part I will consider, only this part I will consider, okay, for analyzing purpose. Now minus 20 into distance, minus 20 into 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 1 plus 1 plus 1. Next minus 10, because it is a hogging, as the load appears, as the load appear, it will hog, therefore hogging I will consider as a negative. This is the, in this way it appears, therefore I will consider negative. If it is in this way appears, we call it sagging, it will be positive. Now I will consider as a negative. 10 into perpendicular distance, 10 into 1 plus 1 plus 1. Next 24, minus 24, minus 24 into this distance, 1 plus 1, minus 15 into 1, 1. Answer is 173 kilonewton meter. Now we'll consider at C, BM at C. That means I'm considering only this part, BM at C, okay? Minus 20 into 1 plus 1 plus 1. Minus 20 into 1 plus 1 plus 1. Next, 10, minus 10 into 1 plus 1. Similarly, minus 24 at this point, okay? Minus 24 into 1. Minus 24 into 1. The answer for this one is minus 104 kilonewton meter at C. Okay, now at the D, at D, BM at D, BM at D, minus 20 into 1, it will be minus 20 kilonewton meter, and at B, BM at B will be 0. Now draw the bending moment diagram. Bending moment diagram, this is a shear force diagram, this one is positive and downward will be negative. BMD diagram, upward is positive, bottom will be negative. First is at A, minus 173 kilonewton meter. At C it is minus 104 kilonewton meter, minus 20 kilonewton meter, and this will be 0. Now there is no load, there is only point load, therefore inclined line, inclined line. There is a UDL, there is a UDL, there is a UDL, therefore a parabola. Next, there is no load, there is no UDL, therefore again inclined line. Negative, negative, negative. In this way you have to solve when the UDL is introduced into the cantilever beam. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.